Menteri Rang Ba Kejela Ukonrat Ke Sangma Ulaong Baka Sorkar Kala Bandang Ha Ban Perkeng Bat Kandang Ha Ban Te Ha Kum Ya Gijing Pintri Kam Ha Barok Wai Kejela Bat Kala Ru Bakan Kam Penjen Surno Ha Kikat Tuk Ani Gibenta Henry Ya Kani Ka Sorkar Kan Selum Biang Ya Ka Jinglong Jingman Ha Po Kejela Na Barok Ke District Bat Hadin Kata An Sabishar Biang La Dang Don Kam Ne Ehem Ban Penjeri Ya Ka Lockdown Bat Kejing Perkeng Ha Kejela Banyada na kejingibit yau kenyang COVID-19. Habakali mendakasngi ulaong ba watla kaladon kejingher jongki ba yibit yau COVID-19 ha kejela kambut pat ban chimsting no. Hendai ke sorkar kan ha ban bicar banyaru ya kejingdon ki ba yibit yau kenyang jipang ka jingdon kejingtia ha kejaka sumar bat kiwe. Habakali halo kejingherap syakinong chong chong ki baduk ki ba shubalasngi. Menteri Rangba Ulaong baka sorkar kala yekren ban lakapor yakni kamat ban nyarap iki paiba. Hendai ke shem yak jing e namar kan don chubun ke jinglut bat lada ai ha ban ai lut ya baro. Bat kumba ka long menta om tang ke jela ka baya kendu jing e ha ke jing duna pisa. Hendai baro ke wai keri India ka don ha preng ke jing hiran jong ke pisa. Ulaong baka sorkar ka kwa e baka nyarap iki nong chong shnong ke bala syak ta apalat na ke jing kangdam. Pat wat la ka don ke jing duna pisa kala persang de ki wiki lat kum ke jing plat ye ki pisa si ki emele ba ki nyo irap ha ki jaka la jong ha ka ba ai la ru ye ki emele ban pelut na ke skim SRWP. Susu ulong pa na kalyang ka sorkar kala persang ru ban nyerap iki pait ba leng ba ka MHIS pat ban si ru san po hajar tingka se ki tu ki long ying ke belak lat no na u COVID-19. Menteri Rangba Ulaong Ru baka khangdam ka ba menta kam long satya kum bala penjari house name ubaladep namar menta la aila ye ki jing trai banya kum ki nong snaye ki nong trai sis pasngi ki nong rep krang ban lait ke jing do nong palat ye ki paitba.
We will sit down, we will discuss you know, after taking the inputs from all the concerned officials because as I said we are seeing the numbers come down, but that does not mean that we can take it easy. But of course, the numbers coming down is a positive indication. Recoveries also are going up. But as I said, it does not mean we can let our guards down. So we will see the trend and we will see the numbers, especially numbers like the positivity rate, numbers like the hospitalization rate. Obviously, we'll also see if there's any, you know, specific growth in any areas. All those aspects we need to be examined. But all said and done, some sort of restriction will still be there. The question is where we can allow more activities to take place is the only question. But really, it's not possible for me to sit here and give that conclusion. So let's wait for the meeting, official meeting. Hopefully, you know, in the next day or two, once we sit down, we'll take a call on what will we do, you know, by next week. So it'll all depend on the trend in the numbers. Yes, it is something that obviously is an issue that has been examined and discussed a number of times in the meetings that we have had. And as a government, we do realize that we need to provide wherever we can support in these difficult times. The difficulty with obviously this whole situation is that the scale will be very large. So we need to, if we support, then it has to be to everybody. And number two, obviously, the challenge of also the finances that are there, which are not that great for the country as a whole. So keeping both these factors in mind, it's not very easy. It's something that obviously we would want to do, and it's something that the government must also try its best to do. And that's where, you know, wherever it's been possible, we have tried to support. So whether it's through the MLAs, by releasing certain funds to them, so that they can then take care of the masses as and when they feel necessary at the grassroots level. So MLAs are doing that, taking care of their constituents. At the same time, you know, we have also given freedom to MLAs in terms of even the SRWP. So number of steps like that where we are allowing, if necessary. Again, it's not a compulsion, but we are giving the option there. And according to situation, people will act. But at the same time, we have also seen that when it came to situations like the patients, the hospital expenditures, we have tweaked the entire MHIS system, and we've managed to increase or enhance the amount of support that they can get to a large extent. We've also decided to give relief of ex gratia to the next of kin. So there have been these small steps that we have done. At the same time, if you look at the entire economic activities, unlike last time where we just went for a complete lockdown and closure of everything, this time it was a very selective process where we tried to see how we could minimize the economic impact on the people. And therefore, to a large extent, agriculture, farming activities continued, but with restrictions. Some construction work continued with the restrictions. For some time it closed down. We allowed the MGNRGO work to continue in certain areas with restrictions, of course. So we tried to minimize the impact on the grassroots, but it's difficult times. So therefore, it's not easy for the people. We understand, but it's not also easy for the government also, though we would like to give all support. We are doing our best, and let's hope that in the times to come, the situation will improve.